Hello, everyone, and welcome to another episode of The Navy Nurse. First of all, I just want to check in with all of you and say that I hope that you are all healthy and safe during these difficult times that we are all going through. 2020 has definitely proven to be tough for many of us, but I am hopeful that we will all be stronger because of this. With that said, I'll get into the topic of this episode, which is joining the Navy with your spouse. Some of you asked me to talk about this subject because you are considering joining the military, joining the Navy with either your husband or your wife. So I put together some stuff that I think would be pertinent to you, and I will share with you these things that I put together. So first thing, you and your spouse can absolutely join the Navy together. You can go to the recruiter's office together and request to join at the same time. There's nothing saying that you cannot do that. And you can also request to go to officer development school at the same time and be in the same class. I don't know if there is an incentive for that. As far as I know, you don't get more money or anything like that for joining with your spouse. Maybe you can ask your recruiter, like if one of you refers the other, if you can get some type of bonus. I would ask that, but I'm just not sure if it's there or not. So there is something that I do want to talk to you about that can prevent you going to the same training as your spouse. So if one of you is coming into the military, say for example, to become a pilot, and then the other one is a nurse, then the pilot is going to go to officer candidate school and the nurse is going to go to officer development school. Let me explain the difference. There are two different training pipelines for officers in the Navy. Officer development school, which is 5 weeks, and that's called ODS for short. And then there's officer candidate school, or OCS, which lasts 12 weeks. So these trainings, you don't get to choose which of them that you will go to. It is dependent on which officer community you are entering. Staff officers such as nurses, doctors, dentists, MSC or Medical Service Corps officers, lawyers, and who else goes? Chaplains. All of those will go to ODS. Line officers such as your pilots, your SWOs or surface warfare officers, your subs, SEALs, all of these will go to OCS. So you and your spouse can join the Navy together, but it just depends on what your job is going to be in the military. So I just want to put that out there to you because I know some of you don't know that or which training you will actually go to. So because this is a Navy Nurse Corps channel, I have a lot of insight into ODS, Officer Development School, because that's the training that I actually went through because I am a nurse. If I was another type of officer, then I could have told you about OCS, but I just didn't go through that training. So I do not have a lot of insight on that. Now let's talk about what happens after training. After officer training, you and your spouse will report to your first duty station. The Navy will try to keep you and your spouse together and stationed at the same location. If you and your spouse are both nurses, for example, it is a lot easier to place you and your spouse at the same duty station because you can be at the same hospital or the same clinic. Or one of you can be in an operational billet, like say on a ship or with a marine unit, while the other one fulfills their shore duty at a hospital or clinic. And typically, if you're on a ship or with the marine unit, there are definitely hospitals and clinics nearby where they can co-locate, where the Navy can co-locate you with your spouse. If you and your spouse have different jobs, it can be harder to co-locate, but every effort will be made to keep you and your spouse as close together as possible. There's always the possibility that you and/or your spouse can go on a deployment. I will say, the 16 years that I've been in the Navy, I haven't really seen two spouses deployed at the same time, as far as in the nurse community. But there is always that possibility that you and your spouse can be deployed at the same time. In this aspect, if you're deployed, it's highly unlikely that you'll be deployed to the same spot as your spouse. And then also think about if you're deployed and your spouse is not deployed. You will spend time away from each other for that period of time, which is on average 6 to 9 months for deployments. So that gives you some insight. I hope that this information has given you more insight into what it can be like to join the Navy with your wife or your husband. I think that would be cool. I would have loved it if my husband could have joined with me. I didn't know him at that time. So, but I think it would have been fun. You will have the support of your spouse with you. So, yeah, if you can totally do it, I say go for it. Join with your spouse. So that's all I have for today. Please be sure to like, comment, and subscribe if you like this content that I am putting out in these videos. And again, be safe, everyone. Stay healthy out there, and hopefully all of this COVID nonsense starts to die down. But in the meantime, wear your mask, social distance, wash your hands, and I will see you in the next video.